Hello. So far, we have been talking about heat and mass transfer in all kinds of situations. We have seen that for simple cases, we could really solve the temperature or mass concentration profiles. Once convection kicked in, it all became more complex and we had to turn to Nusselt and Sherwood relations. A couple of weeks ago, we turned to momentum and looked at pressure drops in pipelines. Again, we had to turn to correlations for the fanning friction factor. However, we mentioned that for low Reynolds number, there was an analytic expression, 4F equals 64 over Reynolds. In this lecture, we are going to derive this expression. For that, we need to think about laminar flows. We will study these for simple geometries and for simple liquids like water and air. As discussed, momentum can be transferred via convection or diffusion. Rather than diffusion of momentum, we could also view this as a friction between two layers. These two layers are stacked in the y direction and they have a different x component of the velocity. For simple fluids like water, air, or syrup, the relation between tau, the friction force per unit area, and the velocity difference is linear. Tau sub yx equals minus mu dvx dy. The coefficient mu is a material property and it is called the viscosity as we have seen before. Fluids with such a relation are called Newtonian fluids. Many fluids are Newtonian, but also many are not. For instance, toothpaste or blood are non-Newtonian fluids. We will deal with them in the next lecture. Graphically, Newtonian fluids are characterized by a straight line in a plot of the shear rate dvx dy and the resulting shear stress tau yx. A low viscosity means a flat line. A high viscosity is a steep line. Just like we did for diffusion of heat and mass, we can set up a momentum balance for simple flows in simple geometries. We will consider only steady state situations. Our first case is a horizontal layer of fluid between two very large plates. Gravity is absent. The bottom plate is fixed, while the top plate is moving at a constant velocity u in the horizontal direction. The y-coordinate is perpendicular to the plates. The x-axis is horizontal. We would like to compute the velocity field of the liquid given that the flow is laminar and steady. All right, why will the fluid be flowing anyhow? In this case, that is clear. The top plate is exerting a friction force in the positive x direction on the fluid layer below it. Initially, there is no other force as nothing is flowing yet acting on this layer. So, according to Newton, the layer will have to move. But then, it kind of slides over the layer just below it. Consequently, that lower layer will exert a frictional force in the negative x direction. Via Newton's action is minus reaction, the top layer will itself exert a friction force in the positive direction on the lower layer. And that layer will also have to move, and so on, until all fluid layers move. Actually, we are looking here at momentum transport in the y direction as a consequence of a difference in velocity at the boundaries. We can make an analogy with heat conduction through a slab of material. Here we found, using Fourier's law, that the temperature profile is linear. Heat is flowing from the hot top side to the cold bottom. For the flow case, we have that momentum is flowing from the fast top plate to the slow bottom plate. Newton's viscosity law described this momentum flow that is diffusive in nature. That is, there is no convection of momentum in the y direction. As Newton's law and Fourier's law are mathematically similar, and since our cases are quite alike, we can expect a linear relation for the momentum profile in the fluid. just like the linear temperature profile in the right drawing. So far, so good. But can we derive this linear profile? Yes, we can. To do so, we are going to set up a momentum balance for a small contour volume in the fluid between x and x plus dx and y plus dy. Momentum is a vector, so we first have to decide which component of momentum we talk about. Think for a minute. Is it x, y, or z momentum? Okay, we expect flow in the x direction, thus it is x momentum. But it can be transported in the y direction. Now we need to set up a momentum balance, starting with the usual form, ddt equals in minus out plus production. The ddt term is zero as we consider a steady state. We have inflow of momentum from the left, the blue arrow at position x. Similarly, we have outflow at the right. These two flows cancel each other, as what flows in from the left must flow out at the right according to a mass balance. Convective flow can only happen in the x direction in this case. There is also momentum transfer from above into our control volume at y plus dy. This is the fusion of x momentum into the control volume. At the bottom, an equivalent flow is present, out of the control volume. Finally, we have for the production all forces acting in the x direction. The diffusive flows can be described by Newton's law from the previous sheet. However, it's more intuitive to write this as friction, that is, as shear stresses acting in the x direction. From now on, we will denote them by tau and move them over to the forces. So, we make a new drawing with the friction forces in it and set up a force balance. Sum of forces and the x direction is zero. Next step, list all forces acting on the control volume. In this case, that's simple. No gravity and no pressure difference in the fluid. All we have are the two friction forces. That is a shear stress at the top and at the bottom of the control volume. Before we continue, we need to be careful. The shear stress is defined as tau equals minus mu dvx dy, and it denotes the friction force of the layer with the smaller coordinate on the layer with the bigger coordinate. If we apply that to our situation, we see that at the bottom, that is at coordinate y, the layer beneath the control volume exerts a shear tau yx at coordinate y. We get the force by multiplying the shear stress by the area on which it is acting, that is w dx, with w the width of the plate, perpendicular to the sheet of drawing. At y equals y plus dy, the same holds. But now this is the force exerted by the fluid inside the control volume on the fluid flowing on top of it. This is not what we need. We need it the other way around. Luckily, we can use Newton's action is minus reaction. Thus, at y plus dy, the top layer exerts a shear stress minus tall yx at y plus dy on our control volume. Finally, note that we draw the friction at the bottom acting to the left and at the top to the right, as we anticipate that this will happen. But in our force balance, we should not use this a priori knowledge. It should come out of the analysis. Putting it all together, our force balance reads as 0 is w dx tau yx at y plus w dx times minus tau yx at y plus dy. This can be turned into a differential equation for tau. ddy of tau is 0. Not the most difficult equation. Tau is a constant with respect to the y coordinate. To find the constant, we need a boundary condition. But we don't have that for tau. We only have boundary conditions for the velocity. the fluid at each of the plates moves with the velocity of the plate. This is called the no-slip or stick condition, and we will use it a lot. Note that we can make an analogy with conduction of heat through a slab. We have now the equivalent of the heat flux through the slab is constant. Also there, we had no boundary conditions for the heat flux and proceeded with the temperature distribution. So, we use Newton's law to connect the shear stress to the velocity. Now we solve the differential equation for the velocity, dvx dy equals minus c1 over mu. The solution is a linear relation of vx with the y coordinate as shown on the sheet. The two integration constants c1 and c2 follow from the two boundary conditions. At y is 0, vx is 0. And at y is d, vx is u, the velocity of the top plate. Substitute the boundary conditions and you will get vx is u times y over d, just as we anticipated in the beginning. From vx we can also compute the shear stress and find that it is minus mu u over d. If we draw our solutions, we see that the fluid moves faster close to the moving top plate. Makes sense, doesn't it? Moreover, the shear stress is negative everywhere. Also makes sense. The lower fluid slows down the higher layers. Hence, tau is in the negative x direction. Okay, we will stop here. In the next lecture, we will take a look at different geometries and what happens if gravity is present or when a pressure drop is acting. For now, try to understand the logic of our laminar flow approach and try to see the analogy with heat transfer.